Hello, I would like to introduce you to a new DC-DC topology called Internally Compensated Advanced Current Mode Control offered by Texas Instruments. Traditional DC-DC topologies, such as constant on time, COT, current mode control, or voltage mode control, provide specific advantages for specific application requirements. However, the advantages are not without trade-offs. As seen in the table, COT does not require external compensation, provides fast transient response, and results in simple, easy-to-use designs with less bill of materials. However, there is no true fixed frequency, there is higher jitter during transients, there is an inability to stack as there is no synchronization to a clock, and there is a challenge to employ traditional methods of gain phase measurements. Current mode control or voltage mode control do offer proven methods to calculate or measure Bode plots to implement stable designs. They offer true fixed frequency operation with the ability to synchronize to an external clock to eliminate beat noise and facilitate stacking. They also provide good low jitter performance. However, they require external type 2 or type 3 compensation, result in larger bill of materials and more complex designs, and have tempered transient response. The motivation to develop the internally compensated ACM is essentially to combine the benefits and eliminate the trade-offs of traditional topologies. This, in turn, results in products that can be used in a wider array of applications. This slide illustrates the differences between select TI products that employ various DC-DC topologies. Internally compensated current mode control is not new. There have been several products from TI and others that have offered internal compensation for some time. However, the compensation is good for a very restricted set of operating conditions, particularly operating switching frequency. Furthermore, such solutions typically degrade the transient response. Advanced current mode control is differentiated by virtue of offering very stable solutions over a wide range of operating conditions without the need for external compensation. It also offers optional features such as body break and asynchronous pulse injection, or API, to have transient responses that are as good or superior to COT solutions. Unlike traditional topologies, the phase in advanced current mode control stays relatively flat for about a decade to support ample design margin and retain internal compensation over a wide range of operating frequencies. COT solutions are well known for their simple designs. It can be seen that the internally compensated ACM results in a schematic that is just as simple. Pinstrapping functions can extend a lot of flexibility to the power designer. Asynchronous pulse injection, or API, is a mechanism employed to improve transient response by reducing the undershoot when there is a sudden load jump. Body break, on the other hand, helps improve transients by reducing the overshoot during a sudden load release. These mechanisms will be examined further when we compare the internally compensated ACM with constant on time. We shall now compare the advanced current mode control with DCAP3, which is a COT topology. To make a fair comparison between topologies, identical conditions of operating frequency, passive selections, and load step profiles are employed. These screen captures provide the baseline transient performance of the TPS-54-3C20 that uses the internally compensated ACM. With the optional API and body break features, one can improve the undershoot by approximately 10% and the overshoot by almost a third. The reason these features are optional is because they have some trade-offs. The introduction and the variability of the API pulse compromises on the true fixed frequency characteristic during the transient. In the case of body break, there is a slight efficiency hit due to the current flow through the low side body diode. This slide illustrates the behavior of a COT device during transients. One can see the extra switching pulses during a transient event. Frequency modulation in COT during a transient event greatly improves the low transient response by quickly increasing the switching frequency. However, jitter, which is undesirable in noise-sensitive environments, is a well-known side effect. ACM uses a clock-synchronizable fixed frequency scheme that improves the frequency jitter performance over the DCAP3 COT control mode. As can be seen, internally compensated advanced current mode control with asynchronous pulse injection and body break offers as good or better transient performance as compared with COT. Furthermore, with frequency synchronization, internally compensated ACM also reduces jitter and facilitates stackability for higher power point of load. In summary, when you need fixed frequency operation and reduced external components, internally compensated advanced current mode control may offer a better alternative to the COT DCAP3. Thank you.